I finally finished updating some of my roads for Trainz 2019 and added some detail for the ones that already were updated to Trainz 2019. This is a three-lane city street. Here we have the same street, but with brick sidewalks on either side of it. This variant has three travel lanes, a parallel parking lane, or I guess you could just call it a shoulder lane, and brick sidewalks on either side of it. This is a concrete abutment designed to attach the road to a bridge section. This is the same road, but it's attached to a blue steel arch bridge, and thanks to the magic of subdivisions, I found out how to make the bridge bend around curves, so it's actually bendy. And all the parts of the bridge bend correctly. This bridge, like every new bridge I make, is designed so that you can bend it as sharply as you want to. This is a three-lane road with a parallel parking lane, a sidewalk on both sides, and an attached tramway with a tram station spline, and catenary lines for the tram. The catenary lines are about as high as the NF10's pantograph. Due to the magic of subdivision, every single thing that's on this mesh is bendable. Though the road probably could have stood to have a little bit more subdivision in it. This is another variant of the same road, but with a different style of platform. This is a three-lane road with a parallel parking lane, a sidewalk on both sides, and a wall to prevent people from wandering onto the tram tracks. It has an attached tramway and catenary lines. I built these roads like this in order to expedite the process of building a tramway, because it takes a really long time to lay down all the sidewalks and fences and catenary lines and platforms, etc. This is a three-lane road with brick sidewalks on both sides and a concrete ramp in order to attach it to a bridge section. This is a three-lane road with brick sidewalks and a steel arch bridge. This is a three-lane road with brick sidewalks attached to a suspension bridge. This is a three-lane road with concrete sidewalks. This is the same road, but with an added lane for parallel parking. This is a three-lane road with an added lane for parallel parking. And concrete sidewalks attached to a concrete ramp for attachment to a bridge section. This is a three-lane road attached to a concrete sidewalk with an additional lane for parallel parking attached to a steel arch bridge. This is a three-lane road with a concrete sidewalk attached to a concrete ramp for attachment to a bridge section. This is a three-lane road attached to a concrete sidewalk attached to a steel arch bridge. This is a three-lane road attached to another variant of sidewalk. This is the same road, but with a shoulder lane for parallel parking, or any other purpose you would want to use it for. As usual, there's also a ramp version. And there's also a steel arch bridge version. And then, of course, there's a regular version with the ramp. And of course, there's also a steel arch bridge version of this one. There's even a suspension bridge version of this one. Here's a three-lane road attached to yet another variant of the sidewalk. And of course, this one also has a parallel parking version. And a concrete ramp version as well. And of course, there's also a steel arch bridge version of this one. Here's another three-lane road with a sidewalk and a concrete ramp for attaching to a bridge section. Here's another steel arch bridge with the same sidewalk attached to it. Here's another three-lane road attached to yet another type of sidewalk. And of course, there's a parallel parking version of it. a concrete ramp version. And of course, a steel arch bridge version. There is also a suspension bridge version of this one. And of course, there's a non-parallel parking version of it as well. And of course, there's a steel arch bridge version as well. And there's even a suspension bridge version. This is a three-lane road with a brick sidewalk on one side and a grass median on the middle. Here's another one with a grass median and a different variant of the sidewalk. And here's one with another variant of the sidewalk. And this one has yet another variant of the sidewalk. And here is yet another variant of the sidewalk. Here's a concrete ramp with no sidewalk. Here's a steel arch bridge with no sidewalk. And here's the suspension bridge with no sidewalk. Oh yeah, I have a concrete version of all of the roads that I just showed you. Oops, looks like I forgot to update one of them. I guess I'll do that later. This is a 32-foot wide, double solid yellow line concrete road. I made the concrete textures darker so that they're actually visible in-game. It turns out that textures that are completely white barely show up in this game. I also changed the textures for this two-lane, one-way concrete street so that they appear more easily in the game. This is a two-lane, one-way bridge that's based on an interchange bridge I saw when I was in New Mexico. This is a fictional suspension bridge I made that's compatible with the same road. This is an unsupported version of the bridge, in case someone wanted to put their own custom supports underneath it. This is a 34-foot, double-solid yellow line asphalt road with no shoulder, based on South 12th Street in Allentown, Pennsylvania. This is a replica of the Mark Basnight Bridge, which connects Bodie Island with Hatteras Island on North Carolina Highway 12. This update makes the bridge more bendable so that you have more control over how sharp of a curve you can put it on, using the magic of subdivision. Look how bendy this bridge is now compared to the past. You can make it as sharp as you want now. This is a 40-foot asphalt unmarked road based on Voltaire Street in Allentown, Pennsylvania. Here's a 44-foot double solid yellow line road with no shoulder, asphalt. I don't remember what I based this one off of. This one is a 40-foot wide concrete four-lane road. This one isn't based off of anything in particular, it's just a generic road. This is a 40-foot wide road with 5-foot wide edges, based on a 4-lane road located in Springfield, Ohio. Here it's a 50-foot wide 4-lane road with 10-foot wide edges, which is also based on a road from Springfield, Ohio. And here is a 52-foot wide 4-lane road that's also based on one from Springfield, Ohio. Now let's see what some of these roads look like in practice. Thank you. Just checking to see if the platform is the correct height for my tram. Otherwise, I'd have to adjust the height. It looks like it's the correct height. This intersection is not finished yet. Tick-tick.